them in this group when you consider that, you know, this is Liquid. You got an EG in here. You can capitalize with Furia looking scrappy. These guys could sneak through.
Yeah, and with so many groups starting with major upsets that have made the group so interesting down the stretch, that would be an incredible thing to have. I don't think Liquid's aware of scaffolding. Yekandar just, OC and Yekandar shut it all down. That is filthy. They almost got caught completely off guard, but some fine pistol work with the USP brings it right back. 1-on-5 for Deaths. He's got to be wondering what the hell happened. He's like, I got a smoke, I got a Molotov, and I got nowhere to put him.
Down and nowhere near the site, meaning that there's not going to be a lot to work with for the T's in terms of a second round buy.
I thought Yekandar snapped to that deep down the ramp kill. It was OC who took it, but that looked like Yekandar just did something freaking wild.
Would have been foolish, right?
Yeah, 1-0.
Sometimes the camera's like, especially if we jump to a different player, someone gets a kill, you're like, whoa, what a flick.
Wait, my brain needs to catch
up. Yeah, exactly. It gets the best of you for sure.
Unarmored Glocks run boost around the edge of the building.
Ooh, it nearly got there. Now Thor almost got caught out, and they're going to follow it up. The aggression continues. He's good for two. He'll drop, but he calls the cavalry, and they arrive. Nitro and OC with the kills.
Yeah. Elige gonna miss a shot. OC gets cleaned up. That's actually pretty solid overall for only coming into this with unarmored Glocks. 2-0.
And Daps sitting down.
Been a long series. Legs probably a little tired, you know?
5 hours of standing up. Nah, it hasn't been that long, but it has been 2.5.
I did that as a coach. I was the pure stander. I paced and deep in a series. You know.
Did you sit down?
No, but it does get uncomfortable.
You guys should have had shoe sponsors. You know? Get the orthotics in there.
Yeah.
Yekandar trying to find an opening as well. The smoke's down on the ramp. AK's already in on round 3. He's got the opener. He's found Martinez.
It's crazy to me how much trust Liquid has put in Yekandar. First on Inferno, we saw on the T side him solo taking Banana on his own, a job that's usually relegated to like two players with a different counter utility setup. Ooh, this is so blind. He's dead for sure. Yeah, no time to get away. And here in this round, the only player defending a ramp initially still finds himself one kill. Off the back of his death as well, OC and Elige hustle over.
Wants the angle, wants that peak, shouldering out to find Elige, who backs off.
Oh, the timing of this is sick.
That's the thing, because Mopez is actually going to be immediately behind them. Well, they all look away, but he only peeks for one, which means they can line up and return, and Nitro does the same. Alex sneaks in, though, and Death strikes when Elige looked backwards to try and find him. Rather, excuse me, Nitro turned backwards to try and trade him. As it's all on Nav, though, and he's close. He's very close. The X-ray turning off. I thought the MP9 hit a sitter. At far range, it's going to be an incendiary down. He'll catch the retreat of Deaths. Does he try and get on this? That smoke's not far enough. He's picked up another one. Now he potentially could. As he jumps up to try and find the angle, drops down, wants to tap it, but he's lost track of where he is. There's an M4 at his feet. I don't know if he's aware. Is that an M4 or a Galil? Doesn't matter. It's a rifle. He's going to hold it, but he's going to hold it. And he's got the kit. He's got the defuse. Nap's going to win out the round. And unfortunately, Alex never saw it coming.
And he got away with the M4 as well. Crafty play from Nasty Ass Naf. Well done. 3-0. Looking good. Almost caught in transition. Three players trying to push up for some aggression on a ramp when they realized Movistar had complete control. They almost get completely sidelined. Plant's going to help out. Weapons drop for Movistar. They still have a fight into this. 3 AK-47s, plenty of nades, pair of Galils on top of it. OC's got the op on the other side of things, and he's going to be paired up with Yekandar. This time, two players to defend.
Shots from Yekandar not going to work out too well, not too successfully through the smokes, but they are still getting closer to that position. You've also got, as you can see it through the wall, Deaths trying to find what's going on in middle right now for the T's. That was almost a slow peek.
It's because, I mean, I think it's because the flashbang came in. He knew he was going to be blind if anyone was there, so OC kind of took his time with that one. Make sure to nail it. And indeed he does, another phenomenal flashbang. Elige has a chance for a double, but instead he does great damage onto two players, but no kills. Oh my lord, Naf had to have been so surprised when he looked up.
Yeah, that's unfortunate for Elige. Good shot, OC takes down Davy G as well, and now the low HP is gonna be a factor, but Elige thought there was only the one, and the second player peeked back out full HP. He's looking for a clean, quick knee shot to finish it off. Yekandar, why? gets taken down. Death's on 13.
1v3, and I think this goes 4-0 for Team Liquid. Nitro with the shot.
Nitro's been quiet in this series so far, but looking good with 4 kills to start off this one.
He's not really designed in any way for Nitro to be like a star in any kind of sense.
Pistols again. Oh no. Oh, a misread. Yekandar does somehow turn around and get away with it, but Mopez finds two. He's been very good. We haven't given him enough credit yet either. We've talked a lot about Martinez, but Mopez has been pretty solid in getting trades and coming out better off for them.
Remember, Chad and I did a podcast with him at Cologne. He's a really interesting player to hear talk about his philosophy of how he likes to play Counter-Strike and how he likes to come up with different ideas. Super unique. 4-0. Nitro, thankfully, was close by to slip into the B-bomb site and hold on to things. But this has spread the defense in a huge way. OC with the AWP has to play extremely passively at A. There's actually no information whatsoever at the A-bomb site. Oh, Nitro hears these sound cues. That's a little bit of a mistake for Movistar. I'm surprised Elise has shifted away from Nitro's position.
Nitro with the first. Follow it up though. Deaths is there. Nade this time is only going to put him down to 6. I shouldn't have mentioned it, poor Liege.
Sorry, that's almost an impossible position if Liege were to stay behind that pillar to clear out in any meaningful way without any kind of utility. I think Davi's just making sound cues. They're coming back to the B bomb site, but this has pulled a Liege back and made him consider. And how far away from B does a Liege want to stray?
Well, he's looking toward middle. Bomb is going to be garnered and gathered.
It's a great sound cue fake.
That's not bad at all, you're right. He's gonna go back now though, surely.
He can't, he's gotta be mindful of mid. Although 12 seconds on the clock, now that he sees nothing, he might push up towards Jen. 10 seconds on the clock, Elise ready and waiting. Davi's gonna cross into the bomb site, he can't put a stop. He can't stop the plant, but he can Molotov it. I think bomb's gonna go down regardless, but Davi's burned out into the open. And Deaths might wanna consider just saving the M4, although when it's this close, maybe you just go for it.
Yeah, smoke down, off angle behind the boards. Elise gonna tap it, tries to bait him out. There for the trade. Deaths would have to be perfectly positioned and isolate this into 2 1-on-1s. There's no chance he's gonna go any further. Reload as well as they continue to wrap around. Done. He's trying. He gave it a good old college try.
Yeah, I mean, he can't really do anything else. That's unfortunate for Deaths. But you could just see they're toying with him. Like, yep, use all your bullets. I'll tap it again. Use the final 7 or 8 shots, and then Elise just gonna wrap around the box. Still, that's not a bad round whatsoever from Movistar. Plant for the extra money. They have a loss bonus that's fully built up as well. So plenty of cash starting to flow into the coffers of Movistar.
He's staring into the mid position. I think he gets one here. He does. Alex goes down.
Liquid on this map with OC in the lineup have been very good at these mid holds. Although Nitro pushes, the follow-up doesn't go well. I've seen plenty of Vertigo games with this Team Liquid roster where that mid presence of OC's AWP is just so very effective. Naf is alone at the B bomb site, but he's walking down the stairs at the moment. He's calling it clear. He might get started on a flank as we speak. There's a timer on this for Movistar. 38 seconds on the clock.
Yek goes out. He's overstepped the mark. Not aware that Davey was that close. Elise is going to hold his position, but now the Molotov will force him back and actually makes contact with him, so they know for certain that he was there.
Ooh, Death's watching for it. Oh, that's so perfect. What a heads-up play, and it all falls into place for Movistar. 20 seconds on the clock. They have to go here. Elise just has to do his best. Going to back off, looking for one. Yeah, he was trying to thin him out.
I thought he might get a lineup shot there, but the AK is far superior to the M4 in those situations. 5-1, finally, Movistar get on the board. High fives all around for that. We'll see if they can build on the momentum. There's money enough, obviously, to buy, though, if you're Team Liquid.
You want to talk about
not any residual after this, though.
Yeah, you want to talk about some thin margins. If Yekandar finds that kill as he peeks down scaffolding, this one right here, if he actually finds Devi G, Deaths turns. There won't be enough bodies to actually make this attack work, so Deaths will stop watching the flank, and then Naf is just activated to get at least one freebie. Yeah, Liquid buy up everything they possibly can. AWP again in the hands of OC. An SMG and a P250. Nitro should be good for one here, though. Awkward as Mopaz goes right through the smoke.
I was looking at the cat's position, see if anyone's going to come around the boxes. That's a nice angle for Elige, but he's not. I see the shadow.
The shadow didn't show which way it was facing, though, did it?
Deuces. That's a pair of phenomenal kills from Mopaz. Five frags for him. Yekandar is going to get one. It took a little bit of time. There's Nap with the P250. Famas cannot convert on the second. They have dropped the bomb.
Oh, HP on for Alex as well. Naf's going to try and rotate over. Only 20 HP to work with. Alex.
Death is making noise. I'm surprised. There's actually a lot of time on the clock. Movistar could make Liquid nervous by being silent, but making them feel like they're going back to the other side of the map. That's a missed smoke. That's a huge issue.
That was supposed to be one way for the corner through the wall. OC is able to stay forward and makes no mistake on Davi. Now they have to rotate over to the site. The huge gap they have to cross. OC's not confident enough to stare down it, though, because he expects they're going to be going for a trade. They're going to walk right. Oh, no, Naf. Oh, no. He had all the time in the world, but he was switching over. OC's going to hit one. Not be aware, but Naf's going to save him.
Yeah, that's the gap created by the missed smoke. That was supposed to be a jump throw, and unfortunately just peters against the I-beam. What a round for Team Liquid to win. Good job from OC Swift with the AWP. And obviously, that's a really awkward 2v2 at the end of the day with all the chaos and all the mistakes that are happening, but they make it work. That's such a quick adjustment. Such an important adjustment because Naf doesn't have the HP to take that fight. If he makes it down off that drop on top of those boxes, Naf's in so much trouble.
Elige, good find. Takes out Deaths in middle. This time they don't need OC to do it. He's over taking care of business against Martinez, winning that off duel. So it could be a 7-1 scoreline here. Alex and Davey G, the only two left alive. And Davey is up in front of the crane. But you'll need a crane to pick him back up off the ground. And that shot from Elige, it's just Alex over at B with Naf.
Nasty little off angle as well for Naf.
He's trying to get sticky keys to work. He's got it right now. Yeah, that's pretty good. You know Naf's not even thinking about anything else either. He's just like, yeah, he's coming. I got him. Off yep. angle. He's not going to go left.
Good stuff from Team Liquid. 7-1.
Go fast, turn left.
That's a little bit of a change of pace from Movistar. They try and catch Liquid snoozing. Not the case as Mopaz gets shut down with his fast play. Middle gets shut down with their fast play. 6-round lead for Team Liquid. This goes back as well, all the way back to the beginning of this series when the map veto happens. Actually, let's hold the thought. Utility out to flush Yekandar into the open. Still stepping in it, wants to counter Molotov. Elise didn't spot anything with his deep peek, spamming in a little bit of damage, and Yekandar missed the opportunity. They just slid back.
Yeah, just trying to find him. Oh my god, the drive-by from Davey G. Martinez has the leash. He was only good for one on the trade. So Naf needs to be careful here. He wants to go aggressive to take care of these pistols, but he's already being looked at. Mopaz getting red like books. And OC is going to color them red, though, with the shot of the AWP that takes out Martinez. It's still down to a 2-on-3, the advantage to Movistar.
Yeah, this is crazy. This is a lot. This is another scary prospect towards the A-bomb. So remember, Movistar had a close round like this as well earlier in this half with mostly Tech 9s. The low economy pistol buys from Movistar have been effective up A-ramp. And now Liquid are going to have to make a decision. Nitro's hunkered down passive towards the A-bomb site. OC is here as well. Do they want to split up and try to defend more real estate? And the answer looks like no. And I think with this lead and with the money the way it is, once this plant goes down, this is a save call for Team Liquid. OC's shifting over now. I can't imagine. Yeah, Nitro's bailing out. All right, back to the point I was going to make. This kind of goes back to the pre-match with the desk with Maui and Bleh talking through the map veto and kind of mentioning, I think even Bleh said this might actually be, Vertigo might have been a good map for Liquid to pick in this series. So the fact that they get it as the third and decider makes this very strong. They're going for it.
Yeah, Maui didn't do too well with the 3-0 prediction, though, did he?
I wasn't going to bring it up.
Oh, I will.
Why are you doing our boy dirty like that?
I will not. Oh,
hello.
Speaking of getting done dirty, Lose the AWP, but pretty sassy from OC. We'll pause with the shot back. I'd love some pizza right now.
Pizza does sound pretty good right now. Okay, sure.
So, Movistar chance to stretch their legs into this game and maybe close it down a little bit. Martinez is looking for the shot up above, holding the angle for any aggression. It's going to be three toward middle? Yes, absolutely. Akinder's already over toward the top of the ramp. He's the only one. That's the Molotov. Oh, hang on. He's got it out. He's got to throw it to preserve himself. He's going to spray it down and get away with it. Nearly. Elige finally puts him in the ground. 11 HP, though. Could have been a way worse situation.
Yeah, he almost gets caught. He caught that. He saw them turn in the corner at the last possible second.
That's like a panic moment. Like, oh, hang on. Oh, wait a minute, boys.
Yeah.
I'm in trouble.
That's like you're holding the trigger, but you're not even really focused on shooting. You're just calming to your team.
But look at this call, though. They're like, hey, guys, let's just all get over here. Save this AK with me. Forget the bomb. This one's gone.
How much do they want to hunt, Movistar? How much do they value this AK-47 being passed over to the CT side? Yekandar is going to go for a little bit of investigation, but doesn't want to commit to that fight because if he goes down, that might motivate them to chase down the AK-47. Bomb's going to go off, and indeed, Elise should be able to hold on to it. Yekandar swings at the last second. No big deal. 7-3. Bye coming in now for Team Liquid. OC brings out an AWP again, full utility. Same with Elige for that saved AK-47. And some money shuffling for the CT side. They're in a good position. A good strong buy coming in for Team Liquid to try and get back on the horse.
Aha. Nice. Well done. And it's a 7-1 scoreline that could quickly go
cheeky
much
Dave.
Different. Yeah, that was pretty cheeky. Could easily slip away from them, though. That's the problem with, you know, letting the money fall as it did, so they need to be very careful in this round. Naf needs to get away. Didn't even keep his head down, just jumped away from it and lets Alex get inside of the site. Look at the amount of flashes. But Alex takes a dink.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Which is so nice to clean him up with that nade. That could have been a very strong position. Davy G and Martinez following it up. It's a little bit delayed, a little bit labored. No one's comfortable. OC unfortunately didn't spot anyone. And ooh, Martinez sees him in return, though.
Makes no mistake on it. He's going to continue looking up toward that window position as well. Make sure no one gets over top.
Are they going to go? I'm interested to see what Liquid's going to do here. Yekandar is clearing mid deep. There's no time for him to really go for the flank at that point, but he wants to make sure there's not going to be any kind of follow-up lurk. He's got the only kit, so keep an eye on where he dies, if he dies.
Nav's going down so fast, they can't even trade it. This is a problem. They need to make the decision right now, and they're going to go. Nitro with the flash. Smoke's not in place, but they are going to nade over. That's going to do damage to DBG. That's going to put him low. Allow Elise to come around. Yekinder's got the other shot. Deaths, he's in a 1-on-2 because he's taking down Elise quickly. Time is now the problem, and Deaths might be able to push through this if he gets the diffuser. He gets the round. He's got it. It's done. It doesn't matter what happens now. It's going to be Movistar on 4.
Oh, no. That's so close. That's so close, and Yekandar was the only one with the kit. With all the smokes down, they couldn't find him.
Look at that. What a hero.
This is astounding that Liquid lost this one. Good shot from Martinez onto OC. He just kind of saw it at the last second. Good shot. I thought Yekandar picking his head off over the boxes might have won the round for him, but Nitro just couldn't catch up to him.
It was. Nitro ran out of ammo.
Yep.
Nitro ran out of ammo.
Yep.
Oh, God. I thought he just didn't see him. He actually could have had that shot and saved it.
And go back in time to Mirage. This is how Movistar made that map so close and probably should have won. It was really crazy situations in post plants just like that. Elige is going to start this out with a P250 kill, but still a lot more to overcome. Still a large mountain to climb in this round with just pistols. Seven to four, three round lead. Keep in mind as well, this little run that Movistar is about to go off of four rounds straight all began with the decision of Liquid to try and retake that B bomb site in a 2-on-3 when they started at the other side of the map.
Alex, the shot, and Naf, you're absolutely right. I mean, this was 7-1 and they don't save, they give away the economy, and now you're at a 7-5 score. I think that's a huge misplay by Liquid they're not going to be happy with when they look back.
Yeah, I think this has started a little bit of a waterfall.
Cascade.
Yeah, it's really plunged the money into a weird situation.
And we said it early in the series too, Jason, we'll say it again, don't go chasing waterfalls.
Yep, exactly. Stick to the rivers and the lakes that you're used to.
God, if it's a 2014, that's a throwback.
The good old days.
When you can was 12 years old. Or thereabout. He's gonna try and peek down toward the bottom of the ramp this time. Smoke already in place. He'll put an incendiary behind it, but he's gotta wait for nade instead. He's gotta wait for the timing on that. That shot back out from OC takes down Deaths. The advantage to Liquid early. Minute 24. Poses working his way back toward the ramp with the rest of his team. Nikander trying to use that gap. Did he see? I think he did, because he backed off, jumps for more information. And an op shot rains over his head. Elige, hang on. Scaff position inside the smoke. Opa's going right up next to him. And Elige is going to back it off. Still doesn't get gray screen, but then he walked back into it and gave himself up. Yekander's got to be so careful here. Trying to play it behind the post because he knew the sandbags were going to be naded. And just like that, the advantage now with Movistar. Deep flash to try and go further around the crane and cover the headshot position. Won't do it. That allows OC to sneak up toward the yellow wall, and he manages one more.
I think he's going to try and get back as well. Yekander was really expecting the next fight to come at ramp. OC, bold position right on top of the crane, right on top of the foundation. There's Nitro swinging wide. OC's gonna come next, but he goes down. Nitro's in an impossible situation, wrapped around, and it's all on Naf. He's gotta deliver one more spectacular clutch. He does have a Molotov.
He's late to throw that out, but it does mean he's isolated him over to the left side. He can't catch Mopez heading out to the bags. He's been a problem time and time again. A 10th kill and 7-6. We're one apart.
Oh, Team Liquid has really lost their grip on this CT side. Movistar is doing everything right. This has slipped completely wide open. 7-1 for Team Liquid at one point. It's now 7-6, five straight. What a round. No money, just pistols for Team Liquid. It's fun. This day has been very labored for Team Liquid. Movistar is just never letting them off the hook. That's gonna find Naf on a very quick early flank, and now that should put off the alarm bells as well to kind of get a little bit passive, because with Naf pushing up like that, you obviously get the information that Liquid know everything that's happening on the map. But they're getting picked apart.
Yeah, they are. This is a huge problem. We're gonna have a tie game after this. What a turnaround. Well done, Movistar, again, to claw back into this. Seems the early lead is not safe. You go back to Mirage, Liquid were in control the whole, or excuse me, Movistar were in control the whole time. Liquid come back and win it. Liquid's in control of Inferno. Movistar come back and win it. Now the comeback again for the Spaniards. I'll slowly clear out toward the ramp one more time as well. Trying to find a shot through smoke is going to fade off of it. He'll rain out that deagle loudly to no avail. Martinez looking up toward the drywall. Heaven spots from bags and Nitro tagged. And might maybe get a kill on this, but 7-7, you're going into the last round of the half. This is really inconsequential in every possible way. Every way indeed. And he knows they're on the left side. He's I suppose the only thing you could pray for is some sort of weird ninja at that point.
Yeah, well, that ain't ever happening.
No.
Not in that scenario. Well, it's up to Liquid to stop this run. Six rounds straight for Movistar. If they end the half rattling off seven.
And guess who top fragged then as well?
Mappas?
Deaths? Yeah. Yeah, maybe you should look at who's top fragging first, Jason, before you
answer
that question.
I saw 13. It was the biggest number I saw with my first glance.
Good effort. NA math. Elige. Tries to evade the fact that they were going for the boost, but he never was really aware. He was just timing that, and it all falls apart. Alex with the opener. It could be a one half for Movistar. That's incredible when you consider where they were at the start of this.
Oh, this is a risky play. Okay, smoke calls it off. Deaths and Mawpaws on the other side of the map just planted looking for any aggression. They know there's been some cheeky flanks from NAF throughout this half. They don't want to get punished by that here. 5-on-4 with a minute left in round number 15. Both these teams just battling so much. I don't know how that Molotov isn't burning him, but now he's tucked in close. You can't get out of this. You're going down for sure.
That's tough for OC. NAF sees the shadow, sees everything thrown at him, and he misses the shot. It's falling apart. I think the pressure's starting to amount, and they're even wrapping around as they went through window, and they cut off not only NAF, but Nitro Alex.
I don't think it's the pressure. I think it's the frustration that is starting to mount and overcome. Team Liquid on this CT side have collapsed.
They need this halftime. They need it. They've just lost 7 rounds in a row. Deaths.
More of it, apparently.
Yeah. Well, a rush. Ooh, or just halfway up. Halfway up the ramp, and they're gonna hit the pause button.
Lolquid.
You like that?
No. No, I don't.
It's better than cats, bro.
Okay, you need to stop it right now, okay? All right?
Smoke's out. Access to the bomb site is there. NAF's gonna hop in with the bomb. No defense being mounted. He's looking for the nade stack that was to come. Second follow-up smoke is gonna prevent Mawpaws from moving forward, although it does block the smoke a little bit. Gives them an avenue to wrap around it, which actually could catch Liquid off guard. Oh, good luck on this retake.
Yeah, I mean, they've got 2 sets of dualies, though. Maybe. Deagles. God, I hate the damn dualies. I always say the deagles. The damn deagles. They're going to go in, though. They're going to get aggressive. We got shots going both ways. Blue and yellow showing up equally so far on the obituary. But it's Nitro that denies the defuse and closes out on Davey as well.
Yeah, well-orchestrated pistol round. But, I mean, Nitro got so much freedom and so much patience due to the fact that no one from Movistar was actually defending the bomb site with no kills out. Nitro can be as patient as you like because you know they're lining up for that retake. You know they're just waiting for the moment to chuck out their utility and go for it. Good shutdown from Team Liquid, 8-8. Finally, they put a stop to the run. Finally.
Yeah, well, it took them long enough, but see if the momentum can go in their favor this time. Deaths goes immediately onto the MP9. They've got the scout for Martinez, and we know how accurate he can be.
Oh, speaking of which, tags Elige down to 28 HP. Not ideal. That's one of the MAC-10s. It's meant to be a little bit aggressive, and now there's going to be no presence on A-ramp. Mawpaws and Alex feel very comfortable. Martinez rotates back towards middle. And Liquid, really, at the moment, all they have left is a hit up the stairs towards the B-bomb site. And with Alex and Mawpaws being aggressive and realizing there's no presence on A-ramp, they can start shifting back. They can take a risk. They can take a gamble. And indeed, they will. There's going to be a lot of players here. Yekandar with an opening provided. Alicia's going to find a MAC-10 kill. That's in middle.
Shot for Martinez, this time not successful as he saw them running over toward the boxes. It's Deaths that's behind the pillar. He wants to get back out, but he's tagged considerably, and NAF doubles up to find his 10th and 11th kill of this game. Alex is all on his own.
All on his lonesome. That's a shame. Movistar actually had a pretty good read.
Talk over me, it's fine. Do it.
I was just thinking it would be a nice backdrop to make a point.
Well, I was going to do that, but then you stopped. Make your point, Jason.
I no longer remember really what it was.
But... Okay. Thought I was the 8th. Squirrel.
Oh, 9-8 in the favor of Team Liquid. They convert the second round. They survive a relatively scary bye.
Do you remember the community servers? I think they probably still have them where it was like, I am the one and only. Every time you were the last one alive?
No.
You never played any of those?
Nope.
Someone in chat's got to know what I was talking about back in the 1.6 community servers that were just filled with all those like mods. Don't worry about it. I was cool, you weren't, okay?
Yeah, that's what it was. Good job with the MAC-10 from NAF.
Alex with his teammates over at B flashed up. They're all sitting very passively. Hope this is pushed back up the ramp as well as the Molotov is set ablaze on the wooden boards. plywood that leads its way to the site. Nade on B is actually not going to do any damage. Davy's able to sneak back around. He's on 66. But Yukinder's there with the AK now to try and pick them off as they rotate.
Oh, and he spotted one back behind the pillar. Sees him escape as well. A lot of pressure Liquid's applying across the map, and Naf goes down. He was on an investigatory mission, and Alex drops him with the 5-7. Nitro has got to play this one passively and be careful. He's under a lot of pressure. Liquid's under a decent amount of pressure, all things considered. Yekindar dinked up, take it down. That's the USB. Alige might want to back out. He's solo. He's alone. Rest of his team now following up, though. 55 seconds. This is a lot of resistance for not a whole lot of weapons.
Alex wants to swing this. He's tried to stay silent in all of this action because his teammates are baiting out this suspense and all of the aggression as the leash comes around the corner, though he makes no mistake as he jumps in. He's gonna try and plant this bomb. He needs to be a little quicker about it. He's got low HP. Thankfully for his sake, there's no utility.
This
is actually massive. He has no idea. OC's gonna give up an AK-47. Did it fall off the other side of the stairs? No. So he's gotta go aggressively to get it. Mopez has.
Oh.
And Deaths has already cleared this. I'm there looking for the AK, and they're getting the kills in the meantime.
Oh my lord. I cannot believe that Movistar has provided this much resistance with what they brought to the table in this round. That's disgusting. Liquid just fell apart. I mean, you got to give it over to some fine shooting. Martinez with a double dink with the USP to take down Yekindar. OC missing a timing on watching the flank. Mopaz again just being a real nuisance. And Movistar have flipped the script. 9-9. Still a full buy for Team Liquid. They had enough money built up, the bonus money from the SMGs, but that's a loss. That kind of a round gives Movistar an immediate bank to work with. 4,600 on Deaths, 2,900 on Davy G. They've got so much cash behind this buy.
Martinez flashed off. Nitro is gonna just sit inside of the top of the ladder. He's got a teammate alongside of him. They'll throw some utility back and forth to reset themselves, and Ali's just gonna come join that party. Naf throwing out the Molotov, bounce that over to scaffolding, and then around they go. Out to middle. So the Molotov to potentially throw and act as a fake toward A. There's no action behind it. This should be a tell for the CTs if they're aware of where that came from. Davy's certainly not, but he drops off. He manages to get a trade. Elige will walk up and take him down instead. And the site is open. They're pinching onto it. Elige is the one with the bomb, though, so we can't wrap back through and cut off rotations. It's Yekindar that has to get in position to hold. And he's done exactly that as Martinez has left at CT. Still a chance for a retake, though, in a 3-on-3.
Yeah, I'm really curious to see how Movistar is going to do this one. Mopaz coming from middle, clears things out. Nade's gonna come in and be ineffective. OC's still watching the flank with the AWP. He's not gonna make the same mistake twice, but he's gonna have to start hustling back once utility is spent. Turning his gaze now, he does have flashbangs to work with for his team. Alige is gonna set up and line up a headshot. Yekindar close up as well, and Martinez has gotta bail out.
He's gone, there's no way he goes at that with the AWP 1-on-2.
But it's okay, you go for that retake, it doesn't win, you get the AWP. Martinez has low money, but remember, the money in the bank is everything now. Winning that last round for Movistar, getting free upgrades to AKs and Galils, has set them up to have another very powerful buy immediately out of a loss early on in the CT half. That's a luxury you don't normally have on defense. Great trades for Team Liquid coming in. That could have been a sketchy scenario. Elige does a great job finding Davy G. Even finishing off Mopaz as well. So nursing this one round lead. A third time out used by Movistar to talk things over before their money is completely depleted. Thought it was a flashbang.
Maybe he tried to throw it to a teammate, like
yeah,
OC, who bought one in the meantime, and then it just rolled through him. I don't know. Either way, we don't need that smoke. Smoking kills.
He might have been just dropping it for a teammate to have some kind of a double, like, set smoke position, and it just rolled a little bit too far. Either way, unfortunate. Three defenders at the B-bomb site early. Liquid might get caught off guard by this. Yekindar is going to find one, traded immediately, and they spotted one at the post. They got one kill, and they spotted Deaths as well, who gets the trade. So now they know. They know there's a lot of emphasis on this B-bomb site, so they have to just step back, calm things down.
Elige didn't spot the head. Mopaz is trying to fire back into it. He's gonna put a nade down there. Chuck it down there. Kablamo on top of OC's head.
Kablamo.
flash. Oh, it's too far. It's too far. Elysia's too close.
Mopaz really took a huge assumption there that nobody was going to be close up. The AWP is going to find the pick. That's Elysia to go down. Into a 3-on-3 we go. Utility's now going to be spent to create some safety against that AWP. Nitro's going to have to hustle forward at the bomb, but he's going to be delayed for the moment. Molotov nade combination does a little bit of damage. It's Naf who's going to provide safety. They might have heard that. Yeah, he realizes that's unfortunate. That might have been a round-winning play, but it's negated.
OC will protect to serve and protect Nitro. Incendiary's late. Bomb's already down. Nitro's already backed off, so he's over toward the wall instead. And I think they may back off this.
I think they're going for it. I think they're just checking for a flank before they commit.
All right.
Two kits. They've got a smoke on the bomb as well.
OC's waiting for that smoke to go away. I don't think he's going to have time for it. Does he have a nade pull? Or is...
That was a
okay,
flash.
It's a flash. Okay, I thought for some reason I thought he had incendiary pull. He's Nitro, you didn't hear that? Okay, he did. He made no mistake on it. I thought he didn't hear it at all because he didn't even react. They're on it again. It doesn't matter. Naf and OC converge. And it will be another round for Liquid.
That's a really smart play from Nitro as well. He's just waiting to see if there's going to be a response from one of the CTs off that tap. Like a tap of the bomb and a teammate swings, or a tap and you get off it and you swing. And he's waiting to see if there's going to be any kind of follow-up to punish him spraying into the smoke. So just patient about it. And he knows he's got an easy lineup from that position. Heads up play from the captain. And even without a fifth smoke, Team Liquid are able to get up to 11. Yeah. Loosen those hands.
Gendar takes deaths down. He's making no mistakes of noise. Just gonna stomp his way up to the site. Sees that shadow, surely. I think he's absolutely going to just keep his aim locked in that to get a free kill when the emergence of Davy G does come to fruition. Mopaz is already waiting as well. The boost and the P250. Elise found him, though. Elise found him and knows there's another one there. Can't find the spam through, though. He might run out of ammo. He's got to be a bit careful. Nitro's going to have Alex. He'll swing around. I was going to say and close it out, but didn't. Didn't, and Martinez is making them pay, but OC is back and in the play. It's 12-9 for Liquid.
12-9. Three-round lead. Rifles coming back out for Movistar. Martinez has the AWP as well.
11:41 local here, so we're getting there now.
Yeah, getting deep into the evening.
Burning that midnight oil, Jason.
Hell yeah.
I couldn't think of a better person to stay up late with, Jason. Just you and me in Counter-Strike.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
I'll bet you do.
Molotov from Naf. A lot of bodies towards A ramp. This time the B bomb site, or the B portion of the attack for Team Liquid is a little absent. No one's really even got eyes on it. They seem very well committed to this A ramp. A lot of utility exchanged. Alex sees Nitro before he gets blind, is able to complete the kill.
Mopaz is able to throw a smoke as well. Oh, and Alex just wants to hurt himself today.
Don't
like Johnny Cash.
That's a good reference. At Elton John.
Johnny Cash.
TLC, Johnny Cash. You've been all over the place with your...
musical references?
Yeah, it's phenomenal stuff.
Just wait until we get to Sesame Street going.
You even had Cats the Musical.
I was about to say.
Really on fire. Davy G making a play down.
Memories
the
all alone in the moonlight. All right, sorry.
Yep, this is when we start going insane. Liquid's in some trouble. Davy G's really kind of closed up this map. Oh, smoke plumes. Yakindar, how aggressive do you want to be? You know Martinez on the other side. He's swinging a little bit wider, trying to grab the angle. Elysia's going to find one right through the smoke. Oh, he's got a second. That's Mopaz, who never saw it coming. Elysia finds a third. What a stellar performance. Again, stepping up to the plate and delivering for Liquid.
Yeah, and individual heroics have started to separate this series. It's been fantastic the whole way through, both teams fighting in different situations. And it's going to be heartbreaking for whoever can't close this. Right now, Movistar has to be so careful about saving these guns. They're going to need the economy if they want any chance of fighting back. Although, mind you, we said that on Inferno.
Yekindar's had such a good feel for when Movistar actually is evacuating to save. And I say that because obviously we had the clutch on Mirage where Liquid thought they were saving. And turned into a little half ninja defuse. Wasn't aware Davy G would be in this position. Davy's got to be a little bit frustrated considering the flank, the play he made down the ladder. To know, to be able to pass all that information, there's nothing more frustrating than being able to make the play that gives your team all the information to win the round and just having it all go to waste. Not his fault, not even necessarily Movistar's fault, just some phenomenal shooting from Alige. 21 kills on him. The third map of the series where Yekandar's been the engine for the other two maps. He goes a little bit quiet, a little bit soft, and Alige is able to step up and be the one.
The high.
Look at that smile.
Sensitivity. It's a beautiful smile, it really is. He's got great teeth.
Dentist wet dream.
Yeah, they're weirdos, aren't they? And here we go again for Liquid over toward B. Nitro with the one-way for the stairs, Molotovs to go up. Yeah, looking for the chance to fire out toward Quad, and it's Nitro that's going to lead the way, having thrown that smoke down. He'll flash and round first. He has the lineup, but he can't get the shot. He didn't hold it down. He didn't hold the trigger long enough, and suddenly the Deagles come back around. You're right. This could be another eco situation to start off the comeback.
Alicia's going to call him back, but there's a snake in the grass. Oh, this is awkward. Davy G believes they're committed to the B bomb site, so he's actually going to miss out on the flank that could drop the bomb. That's on NAF. But still, you have to think OC is going to be a free kill.
Dead.
He's going to be a free kill all day long. So 2-on-5. Now, Liquid lost the third round to unarmored pistols. That was a huge hitch in their plans to run up the scoreboard. Now, again, they have some trouble against pistols at the B bomb site.
And it's not all concise. Okay, they are actually all five going to be coming from CT. So that incendiary is going to buy them some post plant. Elise needs to be careful here. If he goes too far or fires off too much ammo and needs to reload and he's overextended, he could easily get caught out. He's called his teammate back. He's gone far enough NAF down the ramp to know that there's no one that's a threat on the flank. So they've got to go for the picking shots. NAF's got the first. Stays wide. Headshot above the watch. Mompo is up above in the smoke. It's Elise that gets him because he's far enough back to remain. The weapons are the difference. Davy's trying to hold it out. Oh no, he's missed the shot. He's off of it, and Davy's got the shot instead as it goes into Elise's head.
Oh, and a long 10-second defuse for Alex, and they've done it one more time. They've done it yet again. But those are the only two rounds that Movistar's won in the second half, or the third round with unarmored pistols and this one with Deagles. They have yet to win a gun round in the second half. NAF does everything he could. They have to be aggressive. You can't just wait for the tap. Man, at right around midnight. Imagine that. Alige blinded. They're going to be aware of the possibilities here. Davy G's, this is a risk to stick around. Here comes the swing. He's got the first. That's the bomb as well. But Alige is going to be able to trade it off. Yeah, NAF was going to come up the ladder any moment as well.
NAF's throwing again that Molotov toward the scaffold position, and Alex is at the ready. He'll back away into the corner.
Once again, Liquid's kind of stepped away from the B side of the map initially, but they're headed back for it. Alige, that's a huge fight to win. That's going to keep a lot of attention over towards A, but actually, hold the phone. Nobody's shifted. Nobody's rotated just yet. And actually, this might change Liquid's plans. Alige finding these two kills and opening up the bomb site might actually change everything. It's also, unfortunately, as they come over and realize the A bomb site is mostly open, it also buys time for deaths to get into position. But Alige has the angle. And Alige is not going to let Liquid lose this game.
No, he seemingly has other ideas, doesn't he? 26 kills to lead the way.
And, I mean, this is a quad kill round that he's done mostly on his own. But remember, previously, he had the triple kill at this bomb site to open things up as well. He's on for the ace.
I think he's going to go for it. I think he's going to wrap all the way around. He knows it's an AWP. He knows that he wants this out of Martinez's hands. He's the closest player to him right now as well.
Yeki.
Oh, Yeki. You're right, he's found it, but it doesn't matter. Alige isn't going to be thinking about aces right now. He's going to be thinking about spades. And by spades, I mean rounds, because they need two more, and this series is Liquid.
Yeah, he said all the... That's good stuff.
Thanks.
I'm proud of that one.
Shh, don't tell them that.
This is disgusting from Alige. I mean, this quad kill, the previous triple kill, whenever Liquid's needed around, Alige has just been there just knocking off heads. 160 ADR in this game so far. That's mental when you consider we're in round 25 of a very close affair. He's got 160 ADR. Godlike performance on this map. Finally, he's put to rest.
Nitro, every consideration of aggression toward that scaffold position. And Elige, the man who's been so dominant as of recent, has gone down. Boost. Alex gets elevated.
I don't think anyone's really even considering this from Team Liquid. I don't think they expect it. There's the head. There's the easy kill. Dink and completion for Alex. Now Nitro knows there's two players in that position, so he's gonna make up some space, and over the top, he can't transition upwards. That's the bomb dropped as well. OC's looking for it. Mopaw's and Davy G finding some impact kills in this round, and it's just left OC. Ooh, good call.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, they already have an op, so it's not the biggest deal in the world.
Yeah, but he's still thinking ahead. He's trying to keep this one in the hands of Liquid, and that being the economy overall, as that op fell straight through the grass at the bottom even. We reset the round. 14-11, they're still very much in control, Liquid, but that win from Movistar is going to give them a bit of an advantage economically to pull this back. As you say, they already...
That's the first gun round that Movistar has won that previous round in the second half. They finally got one on the board. And considering that, I mean, it's pretty amazing how close this game feels with that being the case. This game feels.
I know what you meant.
Put the S in the wrong place.
The emphasis on the wrong syllable. Nitro. Molotov down at the ramp. Death's just going to get a Liege to start it off again. So the second straight round, the Movistar's had the opener, and Martinez, no mistake, to find Nitro. He's looking pretty sharp, I gotta say. I like the kid.
Yeah. And this is another opening for Movistar where they essentially have three defenders inside the B bomb site. Liquid have not had a great time at this bomb site. They've lost two rounds to pistols at this site. They lost that crazy post-plant situation where Nitro ran out of bullets, couldn't find him. That was in the first half.
Yeah, that was tough. The fact that they're losing out on the econ... Oh, that is a lovely mowdown from Alex. Nate as well on top of OC is going to do damage, and he closes it with the hat trick. The fact that they've just lost the money this late, doesn't this kind of remind you of Inferno?
It hurts a little bit, yeah, for sure.
This is far from over.
I think this is a round where you have to go into if you're Team Liquid with a two-round losing bonus. They're going to get 1,900. Excuse me, 2,400. Had to double-check my maths. I think this is a round where you can't really invest a whole lot into it if you're Team Liquid. That I feel, was like the real punish on Inferno was a force buy that made things a little bit awkward. But here, you got to play it safe. Maximize the number of rounds with the rifle as this losing bonus builds up. And also, use this round as like a timeout, in a way, with these kinds of weaker weapons. Do the old French timeout situation, because you don't want to use your timeouts and also give Movistar that extra time to talk things over, as you alluded to just a couple rounds back.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, that goes both ways. You should always think of your own self in that situation first, right?
Yep.
So even if, yeah, okay, you're giving them time to talk, if you think you need the timeout, take it.
Yeah, but if you got a round like this, take your time, have the conversation now.
Martinez with the great opening shot spots the boosting Elige behind the box, and he still looks down ramp for another same shot, same angle. They go for it, not quite successful this time, hitting it, but they will bring over Mops. He's gonna mop up OC is what he's gonna do, Jason.
Nice shot from Martinez. Follow up is a swing and a miss. Smoke doesn't land exactly where they'd want it to, but it does the job admirably well, just a little bit deeper towards the bomb site, and still, no stress.
No, none at all. Alex fades off of it. Trying to get the boost on the backside of that smoke. They're slow to do it, but they get it in time, and down goes Mampas as he gets nailed by the Tech 9.
And that smoke does come back to haunt them at the end of the day, at least with the one kill. There's really not a chance for a whole lot more.
Martinez ain't missing. Dabby G's going to close out the round 14-13. Here we go.
And there's so much money. Look at the money on Movistar. They should have no more economic worries. It's that's like That's such a weight off your shoulders when you realize you have the money to buy for every single round that's remaining in the game. Especially on the CT side.
This is... I'm honestly having Inferno feels right now.
I'm so impressed with the amount of fight that Movistar has had in him throughout this series.
This is a great series in a lot of ways. It really is. It's unfortunate that it's going to put someone 0-1 to start out the group. Great shot, Yukinder. Takes down the AWP that has been menacing on the ramp for the last few rounds as Martinez falls, and Yukinder's going to advance his position. Sandbags, utility not thrown. Could have cleared it, but he's on solo right now. They're trying to take over mid. He's doing a phenomenal job of clearing out A. He might catch more.
Runs
over. Yukinder taking control. 19 kills now in the game, and forget the fake. He has dismantled the defense single-handedly. He can happily go down to Abby G. He's done his job.
You're never going to point to this match as like a tactical or strategic masterpiece from Team... Death! Oh, that's a huge off angle. Double kill. I think Filiosi's there to trade it off.
That could have been devastating.
It sets up an opportunity, though.
Davi gets here quickly. AK-47 to work with. Molotov down. They haven't planted the bomb. 50 seconds. This gives him more time to reposition. He's going to go around through CT instead. Picks up some utility on the way. He's got another smoke and two flashes to work with. As a flash goes out in his direction, it's perfectly timed. And that allows OC to now get ready. Another flash high. No, excuse me, it's a smoke, so he's forward of it. AWP spotted. Now they know where he is, though. In behind the air conditioning unit, he's gonna open up the angle. With that smoke, he can actually wrap all the way around toward quad, should he like to do so. He can also push through it behind that flash if he's daring enough. Taps the bomb, wants the shot, knows that it's likely to come in behind the boxes, but they're gonna time it. One, two, and three! And in comes Nitro, down goes Davey.
Two chances to close it out. Two chances to close this series. And get away on a day where you do not bring your A game. To get away with the win, Liquid's gonna just be so happy if they can pull it off. I was gonna say, you're never gonna say, Team Liquid, this is a tactical or strategic masterpiece, but the individual efforts here on Vertigo from Alige, triple kill, quad kill, now you have Yekindar, basically solo with a triple kill of his own. The stars, the individual firepower is delivering right now for Liquid.
And I said that it would be Liquid Furia, potentially the most exciting in this group.
Yeah.
This is day one, and this one's sick.
Yeah, you got a lot to...
None of us saw this one coming.
No, you got a lot to live up to after this game. Two chances. Martinez with that off, going to be blinded. He's got Deaths in support, who's up close. Oh, but Yekindar pulls a nade out. He had maybe a free kill. Alicia's got it anyways. Martinez going to be spotted out. Yekindar with the double to crack it open.
Man, oh man, five.
And that might be the death knell.
Yeah, five in the last two rounds for Yekindar, and it's massive, the kills and contribution at the most crucial time. Mompas is gonna try and work his way back through. Alex on the other side of it, 2 versus 4. And it might be low HP on both Alicia and Yekindar. I can't imagine they let them get any further, that they don't play for trades. Oh, hang on though, Yekindar's caught. Nitro was leaping away. This might give them a small chance. The nade's gonna go in. It's not gonna catch out Alige. He's playing safely at the back at the stairs. Doesn't wanna give himself up. Nice shot from OC. Just Alex. He's gonna try and find the first. Mopez actually got that kill onto OC. Does he hold this? He's gonna try and hold this. He's gonna try and be a hero.
No.
Nitro thought he had him. Oh, he goes back to it. And